Dawać.
Check 1, 2, 3, 4. Check 1, 2, 3, 4. Text 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, check 1, 1, 2, check 1, 2, 3, test 1, 2.
right into
just standing here.
No, it's perfect for classical lighting.
I see when it's over. Oh, it's perfect.
Yeah. Okay. That's good. You okay? I don't need to do anything. I put it more to this corner, so that was trying to
for who, though?
For everybody. For the camera, so far.
I'm not going to be in those
right now.
That's fine.
Shooting a little low, though.
Washington Post, and he has got a really bad, like, you can see the have you seen anybody carry off the shoulder? Most likely, it's not like they carry on the shoulder.
bagpipers the same deal? Or are they part-time?
Right. And then some of them I taught still stay in. So they do the same, you know.
But they meet.
Well, we're not seeing it.
hour ago. This is impromptu.
Yeah. Yeah. We don't need that.
Play together.
Yeah.
Frank, are they ready to go?
Yeah. Okay. All right.
I'll make you happy.
Okay.
But I've given a lot of.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to welcome you here with us this morning. Just a quick word, this was originally started as a small prayer service with the fire department Pipers who wished to come down to remember their fallen brothers and to play some tunes for those who are working here day after day. And now more and more people have joined us. I think it's a very good thing that we all come together to take a few minutes to remember and to pray together. Our honor guard this morning is made up of various people who are here on the scene working very hard. We have Eric from the NYPD. We have Sandy from the Fire Department EMS. We have Tom from the NYPD. I'm sorry, I think that's from Port Authority. I'm sorry. We have Bill from Port Authority, Tom from NYPD, Frank from Masaki Construction Company, who put the cross up, incidentally, down further on West Street. Okay, and we have John from Ladder 161 and Ray for the NYPD. We'll begin our service this morning with the Fire Department Chaplain, Rabbi Potasnik.
O Lord our God, in this world, we have sadly seen people with hearts of stone. In this place, we see stones with the hearts of people. Years ago, the biographer of Winston Churchill was asked to what he ascribed the greatness of Churchill. He said very simply, 50% integrity, 50% independence, 50% intelligence. The biographer was told that's 150%. He says, you don't understand, Churchill is more than one person. Each of you has given more than one person. Each of you has worked more than one person. Each of you has loved more than one person. As a people, we will rebuild this site. And as we remember those who lost their lives at this site, we will realize that we truly are more than one people. Amen. It is with great honor that I introduce someone who I think, we all think, is more than one man, more than one mortal, and more than one mayor. Mayor Rudolph Giuliani.
Rabbi, I'm here on behalf of a very grateful and very admiring city to tell each and every one of you how proud we are of you, how proud we are of our rescuers who carried out the most successful rescue mission in the history of this country in saving over 25,000 lives, and saying how proud we are of the innocent men and women who were going about their lives seeking their part of the American dream when their lives were cut short by the act of cowardly terrorists, and how proud we are of all of you who have come here to rescue them and return as many of them as we can to their loved ones, and to make certain that this ground that we're on remains very sacred ground now and in the future. The work you're doing is very, very difficult. It can create a lot of strain, a lot of problems, a lot of things that happen. So we thought it would be very appropriate to ask God's help, since what has happened to us is greater than anything we've ever experienced before. It humbles you, and it makes you want to ask God for his help, his assistance, his guidance for all of you, because we are so fortunate to have the men and women that we have in our fire department, our police department, the Port Authority, and all of the construction workers who are now our brothers and sisters in the same way as our uniformed services. God has given you this task, and you've done it in a way in which you've increased our hope and our pride in America. When I see all of you working here, I know that America has the strength to overcome and ultimately to be able to eliminate and eradicate terrorists and terrorism to protect our children. Thank you and God bless you.
We now invite our pipers to play a selection.
Thank you.
We now invite Chaplain Isaac Pasha from the New York Police Department to offer a prayer for the rescuers.
With God's name, the merciful benefactor, the merciful redeemer, dear creator of all things, as we look out and see this devastation, we call upon you to guide the hands, to guide these workers, these rescuers, that they may do their job in a way that will keep them safe. God, guide them and have mercy upon them. Have mercy upon their families. God, we trust you that you will show us a way that is straight, a way that will bring comfort to them and the entire city and the country. We need your help. We are tired. We are weakened. But in you, we find strength that we will go on to see that this job is done. And God, we ask for miracles. We beg you for miracles. We're in need of help in our hearts and our souls. Help us this day and the days ahead that these men and women will be able to do this job with all the strength that only you can give. Bless us, God, with goodness, and let goodness come out of a terrible circumstance. Let goodness be on the rise in New York City. Let goodness be on the rise in our country, the United States of America. Bless these workers, God. We beg you, amen.
Once again, we will now hear from the New York Pipers, New York Police Department, Pipe and Band, and New York City Fire Department, Pipe and Band. to offer a prayer for the deceased, we invite from the New York City Fire Department, Reverend Everett Wapst.
How fitting it is that we gather here for an interfaith service. Father Michael Judge would frequently say about different groups of different religions and races and nationalities, he'd say, it's all the same union, just different locals. So we are here together, and then we pray together and we worship together. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we ask you to watch over so many thousands of souls who joined you. We ask you to bind them in an armor that can help do battle with the evil that befell us. We ask you to brighten our hearts with the beautiful moments that we had with them. We ask you to take all of these people before you and give them the strength to continue working and help us to bring some of the bodies home to their families so that they can have closure and they can say goodbye in a different way. Dear Lord, give us strength to help all who have been lost to watch over us. Help them to guide us as the days go on, to keep the fear, the frustration, and the hatred of this out of our children's hearts. We pray that, dear Lord, we pray this so solemnly, to keep the fear, the frustration, and the hatred out of our children's hearts. All of you souls, please give us that strength and watch over us. And now as I close this prayer, I'll close it with a blessing that Father Judge taught to me many years ago. For all of those who don't quite understand or respect, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, he then used another blessing. Peace and understanding in your mind, love in your heart, and the children always in your arms. The children always in your arms. Amen.
Once again, we will now hear from the pipe and drums from the police department and the fire department.
Thank you.
Since September 11th, we have been joined here at the site by so many different people, from construction companies, from the uniformed services of the city. We've also had many men and women here from the various military services of our country. As we stand here at the site of the World Trade Center, we must also remember that this was not the only spot where terrorism occurred on September 11th. We also had a terrible disaster at the Pentagon in Washington, D.C., and we lost many of our brothers and sisters there. Let us take a quick moment of silence and prayer for those men and women who've lost their lives in Washington at the Pentagon. Heavenly Father, we pray for those who have died in the terrorist attack on the Pentagon, the men and women who have dedicated their lives to serving this country, especially in the military. We ask you to reach out your loving hand to them and to their families, and to bring them the peace that they so much deserve. As always, we ask this as your loving children. Amen. With us this morning from the U.S. Army is the U.S. Army Band, and we invite them to play some selections for us.
America, land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home, sweet home. Ladies and gentlemen, will you all please join us as we sing one more verse of God Bless America. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless
Before the closing prayer, I'd like to make just a few more quick remarks. The first is one of the groups we should really thank for all their efforts over these last 3 weeks are those from the New York State Police, the state troopers. They're all around the place today, and they've been here since September 11th, and we thank them for the work and effort they've played. We'd also like to mention this platform we're standing on here was not built for this occasion this morning. You know, we'd hate people